Hey everyone, it's Bob O'Mag here for Crisis in the Toyverse, and today on the show, we are diving back into the world of Vinimates. This time, it's with Diamond Select's take on Injustice 2. First one out of the box, Black Manta. Now, Black Manta was, I believe, a downloadable character pack that came with like Adam and maybe somebody else. Can't remember off the top of my head, it's been a moment or two since I played that game. However, what's cool here is that Diamond Select has tried to stay faithful to the initial design of the character in Injustice 2, because as you know, in Injustice 2, you can upgrade your armors and look, so it's hard to get really a definitive look. I guess this would be more of a default look for Black Manta. Of course, we have the Injustice 2 box art and everything, the Diamond Select logo, Vinimates. You flip it around to the side, as you can see, there's Black Manta, ready to rock and roll and kick butt. And then on the back, we see some of the other ones in this first wave. Of course, we got Harley Quinn and Batman, and I will be talking about those later on. With that being said, let's go ahead and unbox Black Manta and see what's inside. All right, so here is Black Manta unboxed. This guy's got a lot of sculpting, a lot of great detail on him, so let's just break it down, shall we? Let's go ahead and look at the head. I mean, those eyes look really cool. Nice, a nice color of red, I think, for the eyes. Some people may want it a little darker and whatnot, but I think it actually showcases the rest of the figure really well without overexciting it or things of that nature. The helmet is really sculpted good. I mean, you got the tubes here on the back that connect to the backpack. That's got a lot of great detail on it. It came out just really, really good, if I say so myself. As for the body, of course, we have the Black Manta body armor here. That's got some nice detail. Of course, this is done in Vinimate style, which means it's done in Minimate form. But with that being said, it looks tremendous. The neck here even has some great detail on it. Of course, he is non-posable, unlike the Minimates. But he does come with his two weapon pieces here that look really nice, as daggers, if you will. And the Minimate has them molded in, so they are non-removable, but he holds them nice and well. And then we got some nice sculpting here on the boots and on the legs, and just nice sculpting throughout the whole figure. Now, mine's a little dirty right now because I took it out for some toy photography. But, you know, it's a really, really nice Vinimate. It's got a nice weight to it. It feels good in hand, and it's definitely fun to play with. No articulation, unfortunately. The DC ones do not have it. But it's a good piece to just stand there and look menacing, if nothing else. So let's go ahead and do a quick size comparison and wrap this video up. So here we are with our Vinimates all together for our size roundup. Of course, in the middle, we have Black Manta. Next to him, we have the Injustice Batman, which will be next on the Injustice reviews. And then on the other side, we have our Justice League Aquaman. So these two can battle it out.
I'm the King of Atlantis. Look at my watch.
So obviously they look really cool with one another. They're fun, they're unique, and I definitely love talking about Vinimates. Hopefully you will pick it up. This guy should be out and about right now, if I'm not mistaken, when I last looked online. $10 or less, depending on where you get it from. Definitely worth the purchase, definitely looks good on a shelf, and happy to have it as part of my Vinimate collection. With that being said, though, guys, that's going to pretty much do it for this review. So I say it all the time, but I really mean it. Thank you guys so much for taking time to stop by out of your day to see what's going on here. It really does mean a lot, and I know it might sound old to some of you, but the truth is you guys are very nice to me, so I appreciate the love. As you know, Redbubble.com, they have Crisis in the Toyverse shirts. If you get one, please send me a screenshot on Twitter or Instagram using the hashtag UCCapesShirt. UCCapesShirt, and I'll make sure to throw a prize, enter you for a prize to go towards you. What else do we got to plug? Oh yeah, of course, all the people who help make the show possible. For all things geekery in the podcast verse, make sure you head over to UndercoverCapes.com today. And while you're on the World Wide Web, you see this pop-up over here in the background that I'm using for my reviews. Head over to extreme-sets.com. And also on Instagram, go throw a follow at Toy Lover Crew for all things toy photography related. Guys, slideshow at the end. Take care. And until next time, great googly moogly!